नमस्कार नमस्कार नमस्कार। हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ ज्ञानेंद्र कुमार। आई एम बायोलॉजी एडुकेटर इन इंडिया। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लैजेला एंड दिस वीडियो यू नो इज गोइंग टू हेल्पफुल फॉर दोज स्पेशली हु आर परसुइंग देयर ग्रेजुएट और पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट कोर्स इन माइक्रोबायोलॉजी और एनी काइंड ऑफ अदर लाइफ साइंस कोर्सेज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट इट। Flagella, you know what is flagella? Flagella, you know, is a kind of surface appendages present in the bacteria. You all know the bacteria. It's possible the bacteria have some kind of surface appendages, and that is also possible they have not any kind of surface appendages, right? If surface appendages present, they can have different type. Like some bacteria they have flagella, some bacteria they have pili, right? And it's possible some flagella have some bacteria have structure that's called fimbria. So in that all surface appendages we are going to see flagella in this video. So what is flagella? Flagella is a kind of, you know, flagella is a kind of surface appendages. Yeah, so this is surface appendages is present, and it's possible this surface appendages of flagella, I mean, it can be possible in gram positive bacteria also, and it's possible it's present in the gram negative bacteria also, right? Now come to their structure. See, in a bacteria, if I am considering one gram negative bacteria, so gram negative bacteria, you know, they have one, they obviously they have cell membrane, and then they have one cell wall, and next to that outer membrane present, fine. So when you'll see the part of the flagella have three part. First part, that is called filament. Second part is called hook, and third part is called basal body. Filament is that part, outermost part of the flagella, which waving, you know, and it's creating some kind of current, it's causing some kind of movement or something, right? Outermost part, which lie external to the cell surface. Then they have one more part that is called hook. This hook is present at the end of the filament. Yeah, at the end of the filament, you see, it's present. But still, it's outside of the outer membrane, right? So, and then next part, you know, is called basal body. So, hook is anchored with a part. That part, you know, is create some kind of movement also, some kind of motion also, and that part is called basal body. So interesting it is. So whatever this complex structure present inside that, this everything will be called basal body. Filament, hook, and then basal body. Now when during scientific study it is clearly observed that if it is the flagella in the prokaryotes, that made up of the protein flagellin protein, fine. And it have many rings also. Like there is one ring that is called L ring. Then they have one another type of ring that's called P ring. And then third type of ring is called MS ring. And one more kind of ring present that is called C ring. not in all bacteria, but some bacteria, it's observed in some flagella of the bacteria, it is observed that this flagella is covered by, you know, the flagella is covered by lipopolysaccharide layer. This toxic lipopolysaccharide layer is surrounding the flagella, you know, like in the bacteria Vibrio cholera. Vibrio cholera is the bacteria which causes cholera in human, yeah. Right, so in that Vibrio cholera, their flagella, you know, is covered by lipopolysaccharide layer, right? This cylindrical structure, filamentous structure, you know, they will weave and they will cause movement in the bacteria. Now come to one by one different part. First part is called filament. This filament is cylindrical structure and it's hollow structure, and it's made by assembling of flagellin protein. Yeah. Actually, the flagellin protein, you know, it will synthesize in the cytoplasm of the cell, and then it will be polymerized here one by one. It will be polymerized, right, from proximal to distal, and slowly this flagella will grow in that direction, from proximal to distal direction, fine. So this is our filament. Next, this flexible structure is called, this area is called hook, and then next part is called basal body. When scientists studied this basal body, you know, they observed that in this basal body, different type of ring-like structure present. not all, but even some ring also move during movement of the flagella in the bacteria. Fine. What are that rings? One ring is called L ring. Outermost ring is present, it's impregnated, it's present inside the outer membrane. Then we have another ring that's called P ring. P ring is present in the peptidoglycan layer of the One thing I forgot to tell you all, bacteria are, you know, two type, gram negative bacteria and gram positive bacteria. Gram negative bacteria have four ring: L ring, P ring, MS ring and C ring, right? But if you will see the gram positive bacteria have only two rings are present. One is MS ring, another one is the P ring. In gram positive bacteria only two rings are present, and what are that ring? P rings and MS rings are present, neither C ring present or L ring present. Fine. Now we will see this gram negative bacteria's flagella and the different rings in detail. L ring, you know, which is impregnated in the outer membrane of the bacteria. This L, then we have P ring, which is present in the peptidoglycan layer of the bacteria. M and S ring, starting, you know, initially scientists were telling them individual ring, but later they came to know this M and S ring is formed by only one protein and it have two domain, right? So because they formed by only one protein and they have two domain, we started to call this M ring and S ring together. M ring means membranous ring. Membranous ring means is present inside the inner membrane. The cell membrane is present, right? And S means supramembranous ring, right? So this supramembranous and membranous ring is called MS ring. Then next ring, you know, is called C ring, that is cytoplasmic ring. This cytoplasmic ring is innermost portion. This portion is called cytoplasmic ring. I hope points are clear to you all. Yeah, it's inner ring because it's present in the cytoplasm. That's why we'll call it cytoplasmic ring. Fine. This cytoplasmic ring have, you know, three type of protein: Flea G protein, Flea M protein and Flea S protein. Flea G, Flea M and Flea S. Yeah, see here. This is Flea G protein. Yeah. Flea G protein. This is Flea M protein and this is Flea S protein. This Flea G protein, Flea S protein and Flea M protein together called motor switch, and they have great role in, you know, switching the movement. Yeah, they have great role in the switching the movement. Yes, they have great role in the switching, not movement, actually direction of the movement. Whenever they have switched the direction, they will use this all protein: Flea G, Flea M and Flea N protein. Fine. Is it clear to you? Flea G, Flea M and Flea N. Yes. Now if we'll see the movement in this bacteria. So this is both side. We have Flea G, Flea M and Flea S proteins are present. Now question is that how this flagella move. So for movement in the flagella, nature have given a structure that is called rotor and stellar structure. Rotor and stellar structure. Rotor is in this rotor and stellar structure. Rotor structure is that structure which will rotate either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Yes. Okay, fine. Clockwise and anti-clockwise, these both rings will, you know, rotate. The rings present here, they will actually rotate. Fine. Now, another part is called stator. One part is called rotor, another part is called stator. This stator have some protein which help in movement of that flagella. And what are that protein? One protein is called MOT A protein. Another protein is called MOT B protein. MOT A protein, MOT B protein. Fine. This MOT A protein. This is MOT B protein, you know. Yeah. I'm writing here MOT B protein, okay, and this is MOT A protein. This MOT B protein and MOT A protein. This MOT A and MOT protein have, you know, they have great role in the movement here. The movement of flagella, they have great role. How they have how their movement, you know, actually MOT A and MOT B protein, you know, it's create some kind of power. It's create some kind of power for the movement of the flagella. The flagellar motor protein must have a power source that allow it to generate torque and causes flagellar rotation. How that flagellar torque is generated? Let's see. Actually, this MOT A and MOT B protein, what they do, they take hydrogen ion from periplasmic space and they pump it to cytoplasm. Okay, what is periplasmic space? The space present between the cell membrane and the cell wall is called periplasmic space. So this MOT A and MOT B protein, they will pump hydrogen ion to the cytoplasm. And when this process occurs, you know, and proton gradient generate, electrochemical proton gradient generate, obviously some energy releases. If you remember, same kind of energy releases during photosynthesis also. And because of this only, ATP used to form in the mitochondria also. So when the hydrogen ion gradient was generated, electrochemical proton gradient was generated, then energy was released. And that energy was used for rotation of flagella. Remember it, the flagella will not use directly ATP as a source of our movement. Yeah, they do not use ATP for the movement of the flagella, you know. How energy will be supplied? The energy will be supplied by this hydrogen ion gradient, electrochemical proton gradient of hydrogen. And who will pump it to the cytoplasm? Who will concentrate in the cytoplasm? So MOT A and MOT B protein, they do it. Okay, now the flagella is moving, fine. Whenever the flagella will move clockwise, the movement will stop in the flagella. Whenever flagella will move anti-clockwise, there will be the forward motion in the flagella. Fine. By the help of flagella, bacteria move. So we cleared the function of MOT A and MOT B protein. Fine. Okay, now students. And we got function of the Flea G protein, Flea M protein, and Flea N protein. They are for switching direction. MOT A and MOT B for maintaining, creating electrochemical proton gradient. Right? Now you see the arrangement of flagella. Some bacteria have no only one flagella. We will say that this bacteria have only one flagella. And if they have two, we'll call it amphitrichous flagella. And if they have so many flagella at one end, you know, we will call it lophotrichous flagella. L-O-P-H-O, lophotrichous flagella. We'll call it lophotrichous flagella. This is, you know, lophotrichous flagella present in our Vibrio cholera. And then we have peritrichous flagella. This peritrichous flagella present in the bacteria like E. coli. A lot of flagella, you know, it's surrounding the whole bacteria. Fine. So for different type of bacteria, different arrangement of flagella present. And this flagella either move clockwise or they will move anti-clockwise. And that causes movement in the bacteria. Fine. Now, this flagella can be two type. One is bacterial flagella, another one is eukaryotic flagella. Eukaryotic flagella like is present in the spermatozoa. Fine. Eukaryotic flagella is made by tubulin protein. Bacterial flagella made by flagellin protein. Bacteria flagella have rotatory movement, but eukaryotic flagella have whiplash kind of movement. Okay. It is surrounded by plasma membrane. It's not surrounded by plasma membrane. The bacterial flagella is not surrounded by plasma membrane. This filament is rigid. But eukaryotic flagella, their filament is flexible. Okay. So in this video, we discussed difference between bacterial flagella and eukaryotic flagella. Then we discussed arrangement of flagella, and then we discussed that how our rotor and stators are involved in the movement of the flagella. We saw actually how MOT and MOT B protein generate action potential. They generate electrochemical proton gradient, and then we seen that how Flea G, Flea M and Flea N actually they switch the they help in the switching the direction. And then we saw the structure of the flagella. Remaining we'll see in next video. Bye.